Everybody, and welcome back to Plastic Models by a Regular Dude. And my next project, the Airfix 1/48 scale Supermarine Spitfire Mark 12. Before I go any further, I first want to thank Jeffrey Strong at Smoky Mountain Modelers. Smoky Mountain Modeler, no S. He had a 100 subscriber giveaway a few months back. Again, congratulations, Jeff, on the 100 subscriptions. Sure, way more than that by now. But he did a giveaway, and I happened to win this. And I was really stoked because it's only my second Airfix kit, and it's my first Spitfire. So let's take a look and see what we got here. This is kit number A05117. 1/48 scale Supermarine Spitfire Mark 12. I think it came out in 2011. So I'm not going to go into this big detail in-depth box thing, but we'll just take a quick look. Information on the Spitfire in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different languages. Then on this side, it's in English and shows the two marking options. Also shows some recommended stuff. But I won't be doing that. It has 98 pieces inside the box. Alright, there are three sprues. Two plastic and one, well, two gray plastic and one clear plastic. So the first one here, sprue A, has the fuselage. And let's see, looks like the horizontal stabilizers, these bulges here that I guess are unique to the Griffin engined Spitfires, cockpit parts, spinner, exhaust, all kinds of little parts. Now in looking at the parts, they look pretty decent. Really won't know till I really dig in if there's much flash, because sometimes, you know, it's not as noticeable on the sprue, but looks pretty good. I'm assuming this is the prop spinner or the prop shaft. And it's got some mold seam line going on there, but that's no big deal because it's not a crucial part. But one thing about this feels like really dense and heavy, but it's probably because these really thick runners going down the middle. But looks pretty good. Now, one cool thing is there is a pilot with this, and I think I'm going to use him. I never use pilots. Well, no, I don't. I don't think I've ever used a pilot. But I'm going to in this case. You know, if he fits right and everything. But that's sprue A. Sprue B are the wings, upper and lower. Gear bay covers, wheels, two kinds. Some that's, that have a weighted look to them, and then some that aren't weighted, which these are the ones that you would use inside if you're doing gear up, it looks like. Horizontal stabilizer control surface, the rudder, prop, oil cooler, instrument panel, all that groovy stuff, more panels and such like. But looks pretty good. These are the barrels for the cannons. I believe they're 20 millimeter cannons, and they look pretty good. There's a mold seam line to deal with, so we'll see how that turns out. You have a clear sprue here, which I'm not going to open up. You have the windshield, the rear portion, and then the sliding canopy, and there's two different ones, so I'm not sure if one is for one version or what, but we'll take a look at that when we get to the instructions. Then we have the decals. So I think he was a flight lieutenant or something like that, Davis, I believe. I'll have to look in the instructions, but his markings are here, and I think that's the version I'm going to go with. Apparently, he was quite the multiple ace. These are all the decals that go for both versions, and then these are specific to whichever one a person is doing. So that is the decals. They look, I can't really tell. They're cut real close. It looks like they're printed real close. The carrier film is not very prominent, but we'll see once we get them applied. But shouldn't be too bad. And we have the instructions. English, French, German, Spanish, and Swedish, maybe? I don't know. I'm not sure. But here we go. Here's the instructions. Pretty self-explanatory, pretty straightforward. Looking pretty groovy. Now, I say I'm going to use the pilot, but, you know, even if I use the pilot, he's going to be on the tarmac. Extended landing gear, all that kind of stuff. But looks pretty straightforward. So here are the options. Yeah, Flight Lieutenant Donald Smith. Couldn't remember. I said Davis. Yep, was way off. Donald Smith. Number 41 Squadron, Royal Air Force, Tangmere, Sussex, England, October 43. Now right here you can see I've got my colors labeled in Tamiya numbers because that is the colors that I'm going to be using. I'm going to be using Tamiya colors, and these are supposed to be the equivalents or really, really close to being the equivalents. So, that's the color scheme I'm going with right there. Flight Lieutenant Donald Smith. All right, so let's talk about the colors real quick. Number 30, dark green. The equivalent is XF-81, which is, oddly enough, dark green 2 RAF. So that's cool. XF-21, beige green. Approximate sky, XF-21, sky, tra-la-la, ocean gray, 106, XF-82. Now that color is just way, way different. Man, see that little swatch doesn't even match that color there. So don't go off of that. It should be this, which is ocean gray, which is ocean gray 2 RAF. It's kind of cool that to me is making specific stuff like that. And then we have medium sea gray XF-83, medium sea gray 2 RAF. So those are the colors I'm using. Now I use bees and other basic colors for detail painting and stuff like that. For the decals, I'll be using probably micro set. To put them in place, and then I will use Solvacet for getting them to melt into the detail. Now I'll try Microsol first, but if that's not strong enough, I'll use the Solvacet. For my glues, I'll be using my usual Tamiya Extra Thin, probably more the Extra Thin, not the quick setting, because this quick setting is a little hotter, and this plastic on Airfix kits seems to be really soft from what I've heard and what I've experienced on the one Airfix kit that I've done. I'll also be using this for certain things. It's a thicker liquid Model Master, and then I have Model Master clear part cement and window maker. Then I have my usual super glues and stuff like that, in case I need that for anything. But other than that, that's pretty much it. Probably for most of my airbrushing, I will most likely be using the Iwata HP-M2. because I will be masking this pattern off to do the spraying. One thing that's kind of cool about the Spitfire here is it's got a hard demarcation between the medium sea gray underneath and the camo color, so I'll be able to tape that off nicely, and should make it a little bit easier to paint, not have to worry about, you know, the fuzzy edge. So that is the paint and supplies I'm going to use. So there you go. That is the that's the kit right there. The Spitfire Mark 12 by Airfix in 1/48 scale. So thanks for joining me for this introduction, and stay tuned. I will be trying to release a video of progress at least once a week during the construction phase of this, and then I will give my thoughts as I go along, and I will give my thoughts at the end on anything that I ran into that I found disturbing or just things to note. And this will be a step-by-step build, and hopefully the paint portion of it won't fall apart like usual. That's the hardest part to video. But anyway, that's it. That is the intro to the next project, Spitfire Mark 12. So hope you enjoyed this. If you have any experience with this kit and would like to share any hints, tips, or suggestions, anything like that, put them in the comments section down below and I will respond as quickly as I can. So as always, thanks for watching, and I will see you all later.